पार्टिसिपेंट्स, नो पार्टिसिपेंट्स। ओके, नो पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर जॉइनिंग। एम आई ऑडिबल फारूक?
यस सर।
ओके, सो टुडे आई एम इन योर FMHM लैब। ओके, सो वेदर द साउंड इज इकोइंग और इट इज परफेक्ट फाइन?
फाइन सर, फाइन फाइन।
एंड वीडियो इज कमिंग? माय वीडियो कैन यू सी?
नो नो नो।
ओके, लेट मी चेक। How to switch on the video? Spotlight video, it is showing. Oh, video, it must be coming. Once again, you see?
Yes, sir, it is coming. Okay, sir, done.
Okay, let me check how to change the position of camera. Yeah. Can you see now what I am showing on the camera? List of experiments.
Yes, sir.
Is it visible?
No visible.
Okay, very good. So likewise, along with me, Navin sir is there. He will be helping me, okay, to handle this camera, and I will be explaining what are the different experiments do we have, and I will show you the experimental setup also for the different experiments. What are the different components? Okay, like whatever we have learned till now in our theory, what is venturimeter, what is orifice meter? Okay, we have seen those things theoretically only. Okay, if you will see here, one valve kind of thing is here. Okay, so this is actually your venturimeter, what you have studied in your theory lecture. So one by one, I will show you for all the experiments, or for the experiments that we have studied in our theory subjects till now. Okay, so let's see how many participants do we have now. 14 participants today. Also, is there any means backlog exam is there?
Yes sir, I think so. First year backlogs.
Okay. So I will start because there may be restriction with the battery of this mobile phone. Okay, so I'm starting. First, Navin sir, you focus on that list of experiments. Yeah, so if you are able to see, this is your list of experiments, and the first one is your impact of jet on vanes. Okay, we will provide you the list. Just I am showing you how it looks like so that you can get some real experience of this labs. Okay, the second one is your performance test of Pelton wheel. Okay, Pelton wheel. The third one is your Francis turbine, and the fourth one is your Kaplan turbine. Okay, so these are all your three turbines. We will study it in your unit number 5. Okay, that we have not studied yet. Now coming to your experiment number 5 and 6, if you can see your screen, it is performance test on single stage centrifugal pump, and the next one is your multi stage centrifugal pump. So first you need to understand what is centrifugal pump, what is reciprocating pump, what are the difference between them. That we will see in your unit number 6. Okay, so we will study about this pumps, centrifugal pump or reciprocating pump, their characteristic curves, their working, everything we will study in your unit number 6. Coming down to your experiment number 8, it is your venturimeter. Okay, venturimeter, orifice meter, and pitot tube. If you remember, we have categorized these three things. things in practical application of Bernoulli's theorem. That is very important for your competitive exam point of view also. So you all keep in your mind, practical application of Bernoulli's theorem. What is those practical application of Bernoulli's theorem? Venturi meter, orifice meter. These two we use to calculate the flow across a pipeline. Okay, so we will do the calibration of Venturi meter, means we will measure the coefficient of discharge. Okay, CD value that you have remember in your formula is there, na? CD value, how to calculate that? It is the ratio of your actual flow upon ratio of your theoretical flow. That is your coefficient of discharge. So coming to experiment number 9, the same thing, we will do it for your orifice meter. Okay. So these are your 9 experiments. Coming down to experiment number 10. Determination of friction factor for a given pipeline. We all are now going through that Darcy-Weisbach equation. We have studied frictional losses, minor losses, major losses. Okay. So as I have told you, major loss is nothing but the frictional loss. So we will calculate for different material. Suppose you have copper pipe. Suppose you have aluminium pipe. Suppose you have mild steel pipe. Materials are different. Okay. But we are using it for flow of the water or any other fluids. So how the friction factor is varying for different materials. Okay. So that we will see through experiment, how to calculate the friction factor for a given pipeline. This is your experiment number 10. Now coming to experiment number 11, determination of loss of head due to sudden contraction in pipeline. Okay. So this is your minor losses. Minor losses, if you remember, there are loss due to sudden expansion or sudden contraction is there. Okay. And along with if there is some fitments in the pipeline or if there is any obstruction in between the pipeline, those everything comes under the category of your minor losses. So these are major losses and minor losses. So for major loss, we will calculate the friction coefficient. For minor loss, we are going to determine the loss of head due to sudden contraction in the pipeline. Okay, this is your experiment number 11. Okay, coming down to the last experiment, verification of Bernoulli's theorem. Very, very important, this Bernoulli's theorem. Once again, I'm telling you, okay, please pay attention, not only for your lab session or your theoretical subject, but it will be applicable for your entire competitive examinations also. Okay, what is that? Entire fluid mechanics subject. Entire fluid mechanics subject. You can categorize it in 3 principles. 3 physics principles. Am I audible? Please respond. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 3 basic physics principles keep in your mind. The first one is conservation of mass. Can anyone tell me in the classroom what is conservation, law of conservation of mass? Yes, anyone? What do you understand by law of conservation of mass? Gautam, you have studied in your basic physics.
During chemical change, no loss or no gain of atoms.
Yes, very good. Energy, like you have studied if in your conservation of energy, energy neither created nor it is destroyed. Similarly, mass is neither created nor destroyed. Okay. So conservation of mass, if you will see in that category, what will come? Continuity equation. That Q, if you remember, Q equals to A into V, where A is the cross-sectional area of this pipeline, and B is the velocity through which the fluid is flowing inside this pipeline. Okay, so this is your continuity equation that you remember, that A1 V1 equals to A2 V2. But what is the physical significance? Physical significance is, this is a very conceptual question. I'm telling you, it can be asked for your interview at BARC, ISRO, or any competitive examination. Okay. So the physical significance is whether the diameter of this pipeline is going to change after this or not. Your discharge, whatever is coming at the inlet of this pipeline, the same discharge, it will remain throughout to compensate the cross-sectional change of this pipe. Suppose here the area is A1, here the area changing to A2. Okay, so for the compensating of that area, velocity will change. Okay, so that's why we called Q equals to A1 V1 equals to A2 into V2. So this is the physical significance of your continuity equation, and this comes under the category of, some call is coming. Yeah, is it going on? I will not see what you are writing in your chat box. Okay, so because I'm on camera mode, so you have to reply through your audio device, so that I'll be here. I have Bluetooth headset, so that whatever you will say, I can hear. Okay, so please don't respond in the box. One by one, you have to speak. If simultaneously two or three students will speak, then I'll be able to understand. Okay, so I was talking about continuity equation is the physical significance of your continuity equation that is based on the principle of law of conservation of mass. Always remember, okay, law of conservation of mass. Whatever the mass is here, the same mass flow rate will be in your, the second state also. This is law of conservation of mass. Now, coming to law of conservation of energy. Okay, if you remember that, you are remembering about your Bernoulli's equation. Okay, Bernoulli's equation. What we were studying? If in a pipeline, suppose this thing, you can see the cross section is changing. Here you have section. Gradually, the cross sectional area is changing. The cross sectional area is changing. And again, the cross sectional area is increasing. Okay, what I mean to say, as we have studied, okay, when the area is reducing, what will happen? Velocity will increase or decrease?
Increase.
Velocity will increase. Very good. Okay, so if the velocity will increase, at the same time pressure head will
decrease.
Yes, very good. Okay, so this is nothing but the physical significance of your Bernoulli's theorem. Okay, this is nothing but, it is based on the principle of conservation of energy. Okay, continuity equation was conservation of mass. This is your conservation of energy. So the definition that you remember, the sum of pressure head, sum of kinetic head plus datum head. Okay, pressure head you are representing with P upon rho G. Okay, pressure head. Kinetic head V square upon 2G plus datum head. Datum head is what? That is your reference line. For this experiment, datum head, I am considering the center line of this pipeline. Okay, the sum of pressure head, kinetic head, datum head equals to constant. Okay, so if we are writing it for two different sections, suppose this is section number one, this is your section number two. So whatever will be the pressure head at this location, kinetic head at this location, datum head at this location, will be equals to the sum of those three energies over here also. Okay, this is the working principle of your Bernoulli's theorem or your Bernoulli's experiment also. Okay, so in one line, takeaway point, you can take down or you keep in your mind, law of conservation of energy. Bernoulli's experiment is working on law of conservation of energy. As I have told you, entire fluid mechanics is based on these three conservation law. The first one is law of conservation. Wait. Now it is fine? Okay. It is coming on the screen now. Again now, back. Yeah, it is coming. As I have told you earlier, entire fluid mechanics is based on three conservation law. Law of conservation of mass, as I have told you, that is your continuity equation. Always remember, okay? The second one I have shown you, conservation of energy. What is the third principle? Can anyone guess?
Venturi meter.
No, Venturi meter, it is application of your Bernoulli's theorem. I'm talking about conservation laws. Law of conservation of mass, I have told continuity equation. Law of conservation of energy, I told you this Bernoulli's equation, because here we are saying that the sum of all the energy, namely pressure head, kinetic head, datum head will remain constant. Okay, so here we can say energy is neither created nor destroyed. Okay, energy is conserved. Okay, so similarly, we have law of conservation of momentum also. If you will see here, impact of jet on vanes. Okay, in the previous theory class, background light is coming or clear picture is coming. This side, okay. Okay, in the previous lab sessions, we have seen the theoretical explanation of your impact of jet on vanes. In what? In that, what we are doing? We were doing some calculation, if you remember, Newton's second law of motion. Okay, Newton's second law of motion, we are saying that force is nothing but rate of change of momentum. Okay, and if you will go with the basic definition of momentum, it is nothing but your product of mass into velocity. Okay, but here what I am saying, here I am saying rate of change of momentum. Okay, so here I will not consider only mass. Instead of that, rather I will take mass flow rate. Okay, mass flow rate. Here, if you will zoom it, sir, please come in closer. If you will see here, I will show you, for some time your hand will get rest. Yeah. If you will see on the screen, that conical part, okay, that conical part is nothing but your nozzle. In that nozzle, there is some hole. You can see circular hole is there. From that, water will hit straight to that semi-spherical cup is there. We will do it for two different surfaces. This you can see on the screen. A flat plate is there. And the second one that is installed right now in the setup, that is your hemispherical cup is there. Okay, so we will see one by one, both of them. Okay, now try to understand. I have told you about conservation of mass. I have told you about conservation of energy. Now this is conservation of momentum. Okay, here we are going with conservation of your momentum. Okay, so on that, this impact of jet on vanes is based. Now, why do we need to study this impact of jet on vanes? Can anyone guess? Any guess? What is the practical application of this impact of jet on vanes?
Power plant and thermal water power plant.
Because we study this impact of jet on veins, we will came to know how much water we are impacting on any flat plate or hemispherical cup. Using that principle or using that method, we can study different turbines. Turbines, okay. If you will see, I will show you one turbine diagram is here. Okay. On diagram here, I am showing first. If you see here, one Pelton wheel is there on the screen. Yeah. If you focus on one cup or one blade of this turbine, okay. So from here we start. From here, one blade representation is there in the next diagram. This is the blade profile, and this is your side view, as we have studied in your last class, last practical class. Okay, before your examination, this blue color is representing your jet of water that is hitting your blade. Blade is hatched with black color and the material is in yellow color. Okay, that blue color water jet is striking your blade. So based on that impact of jet on veins, this turbine works. Okay, so that's why we need to study these. See here, I will show you an actual picture also. Yeah, this is the actual picture. Inside you can see these are the different cups. These are the different cups and they are connected on a circular disc. Okay, and from here you can see this pipeline. This pipeline is there from where the water is coming and this jet is there. One jet is there. I'll try to show you, but I don't know whether the light is there inside this. No, it is not clearly visible. Okay. Okay. I can change the camera orientation. Okay. Yeah. Yes. It is visible. So these are the different cups. You can see slow rotation, sir. Slow rotation. And the one you can see on the top, that is the nozzle through which water will come and it will strike the bucket. Opposite direction. Yeah. Once that jet of water will strike this water bucket, this will rotate. And this is how your turbine operates. Okay. This is how your turbine operates. So to understand the working of this turbine, we first need to study with single bucket, with single flat plate. Before bucket also, we need to study with flat plate. If we strike a jet of water on a flat plate, what will be the forces over there? How much force a jet of water will create? Okay, so for that, we will study, in theory, we will study flat plate, we will study inclined plate, we will study curved plate, we will study moving flat plate, moving curved plate. This all we will study in your unit number 4, I think. In your unit number 4, we will study all this impact of jet on veins. And based on these principles, we will see the working of all the turbines that you have seen over there. Okay, all the three turbines are there. Pelton wheel, Francis turbine, and the Copeland turbine. So to study their performance, we need to first understand how this impact of jet on veins is working. So I will try to first start with this experiment only. Okay. I will switch the camera to opposite side. Yeah. Now you can see here, one collecting tank is there. This is your collecting tank. Okay. Then you have a pump over here. This is the pump. Okay. Basically, as a mechanical engineer, by just looking onto the size of this motor, or you can say the pump, you can tell the specification. I think it is of 1 HP power. Somewhere it will be written over here. written half HP. 0.5 HP, you can see here. Okay, this is half HP of motor capacity. On this side, you all know that inside this motor, there is nothing but one spindle will be there. Okay, on that, some copper windings will be there. That is called as your armature. Okay, and that is rotating. And with that rotation on this side, this part, one impeller is mounted on that spindle or your armature. It is sucking the water. This is your suction side of the pump. It is going to your collecting tank. Okay, this is your collecting tank. Now we don't have water inside it. But in the next lab, I will fill this collecting tank with water also, and I will show you the working. Today, you try to understand all the different components that is there in this experimental setup. So this is the collecting tank where we will be having water filled in it. This is your pump. Basically, it is centrifugal pump. You all remember, this is centrifugal pump. It is asked in your Viva examination. This is the suction side of the pipe. Now, opposite side, this green pipe. This one, this is your delivery pipe. Okay. And this delivery pipe, you will see it is going to this valve. What is the working of a valve? Anyone in the class? What is the working of the valve?
To increase or decrease the pressure.
To regulate the flow rather. Okay. To increase or decrease the flow. Okay. Mass flow rate you are regulating. Flow rate better. Okay. If you will close it, then water will not flow through it. If you will open it, then more water will be flowing through it. Okay, so this is to regulate the flow of water across this pipeline. Okay, after this is your pressure gauge. It will tell you what is the pressure. Here, if you will see in the dial gauge, come closer. Yeah, here if you will see, two markings are there. One is written 5 here on the inside. And this is 0.5 is written on your outer scale. Two scales are there. Inner scale, outer scale. Why? So here you can see two units are there. The first one is our LB per inch square. LB stands for pound. Okay. And this kg is kilogram per centimeter square. So these are the two units in which you can take the value. Okay. We will go for kg per centimeter square. Pound per inch square is used in your US or European countries. Now, through this, water will come and then it will come to your nozzle. Okay, the nozzle you can see there. Through that nozzle, there is one hole is there through which the water jet will go and vertically hit that spherical cup. So how we will measure the force? For that, this portion is there. You can see this red color lever. This red color lever is there. First, I will show them. Here, you can see two markings are there. First, you have to make such an arrangement that they both the lines, the line in on this yellow color, this metallic plate is there. And one line is here on your glass is there. So we have to balance it using this counterbalance. Okay, if you remember in your physics, we have studied load into load arm equals to effort into effort arm. So what I'm basically doing, this is your fulcrum point. In your mechanics, you might have studied fulcrum point, okay, on which this is hanging actually. This is your counter load. And on this side, this counter load you can adjust. See what I'm doing. I'm rotating this, and this is going on this side. Means the load is going on that side. So, see here. Now, this line is going upside. So, we have to make some arrangement. Thoda back view lijiye ki pura yahan se yahan dikhai de. Okay. We have to rotate this and we have to see for the position where this both line should coincide. Yeah, this is the location. Now you can see both the lines are coinciding. Okay, now we will add, this is the weight. There is one weight in my hand. I think this is for 100 grams. 100 grams weight is there. Now I will add this weight here. One hook is there on this red plate. One hook is there. From this hook, we can add weight on it. Now see, this is again changed. You keep the camera a little bit away so that they can see the entire frame. Okay, from here it is coming. Not looking. Yeah, this is fine. Oh-ho. Yeah. Is it clearly visible to all of you? Here you can see two lines that I was talking about. Okay. Two lines are here. So I have added one weight over here at this location. Okay. Just to give some weight on it. Now what we will do, we will start the motor. The water will be coming through this and it will be hitting that spherical cup. That cup is connected to this red plate here, you can see. Slowly by slowly I will show you. See, the plate I am moving, that cup is also moving. Okay, that water will be hitting that spherical cup. And we have to adjust the flow rate using this valve so that it will create only that much of force through which it can counterbalance this weight. Okay, then we have to make certain, we have to record certain data like what is the flow rate. And for flow rate, you have done some small experiment at your home that I have already told you. So you can see the water is not allowed to move outside. It will accumulate here in this tank. You can see here. Yeah. One scale is there. On this scale, the height of this tank is given. Okay. The cross-sectional area of this tank is given to you as an input. If the cross-sectional area of this tank is known to you, cross-sectional area, and for rise of 10 centimeter in this tank, how much time it is taking? For rise of 10 centimeter height, suppose the cross-section of this tank is 25 mm this side, 25 mm this side. Okay, so what will be the area? 25 into 25. Okay, now I'm telling for 10 centimeter rise. What will be the volume? 25 mm into 25 mm into 10 mm. What value you are getting? Yes? What value you are getting? Please respond.
250.
625 and 10 will be there. 25 into 25 will give you 625 and into 10. So it will be 6250 mm. Again,
yes,
oh, this is, this I am telling for 10 centimeters. So that also you can convert in mm. So it will be 100. Okay, so 625 into 100, so 20 will also come. It is in mm cube. Okay, you can convert this entire thing into meter also. So you will get meter cube. This much volume, suppose that value is coming as 1000, for say I am telling you, okay, 1000 meter cube. That will be very large amount. Keep it as 1 meter cube. Okay. suppose that value is coming at 1 meter cube. So for accumulation of that much of water, how much time it is taking, you can calculate using one stopwatch, or in your mobile phone also there is one stopwatch. So from here we can know what is the actual flow rate. Okay, so there are certain calculations with it. We have to perform that with 3 different weights, starting with 100 gram, 200 gram, then 300 grams. With these 3 different weights, we can do this experiment for this impact of jet on whales. So in the next lab, we will perform this experiment. Coming back again to your venturi meter. I want to show you this venturi meter. What you have drawn in your notebook. Yeah, here from this side. You can see. Back view I am showing you because from this side the background light is coming, so it will not be clearly visible. As you can see here, the diameter is reducing. In your theory, we have seen converging portion, then one flat portion. This is your throat. This is your throat. And again, diverging portion means the cross-sectional area is increasing. So this is your venturi meter. Okay. Now, in venturi meter, you are plugging one U-tube manometer. You are applying now to measure the pressure difference. So here are those 2 pipelines. One is connected to the normal diameter of the pipe. Okay, this pipe. Where this pipe is going? See. This pipeline is going connected to here. Okay. And this is connected to this end. This is your U-tube manometer. U-tube manometer. Inside you can see one shining liquid is there. This is your mercury. This is your mercury. What is the specific weight of mercury? Anyone? What is the specific gravity of mercury? We have 32 participants. Okay. And one simple question I am asking. What is the specific gravity of mercury? So many numericals we have solved.
13.6.
Yes. 13.6. So like this. Yes, like this you have to tell, okay? So specific gravity of your mercury is 13.6, that you can see here, it is your U-tube manometer. What you have studied till now, okay? In your theory, now you are able to see here, okay? So the one tapping, this is called as your tapping, is connected to the normal pipe diameter here. That is coming to this side of your manometer, connected to one part of your manometer. And the second tapping, it is made at the throat location of your venturi meter. Okay. So this part is coming. Now see this white pipe. It is coming and it is connected to this side. Okay. So it is connected to the another portion of your manometer. Okay. Ideally, these 2 mercury levels should be at the same level. Okay. But there are certain back pressures since from long time these machines have not run. So you can see there is small deflection. On the left hand side, the mercury column is on little bit downer side. Okay. So we have to make some adjustments for that. Since this machine has not run for I think more than 6 or 8 months, isn't it, Naveen sir? Yeah. So we have to make certain adjustments. Now you can see it is somewhat at the same level. So how we have to see, we have to bring one scale and we have to see what is the level difference. So this is about your venturi meter. Again, if you will see, we are having one connecting tank over here. This is common for all the experiments because we are dealing with your fluids. So we will be having a collecting tank, suction pipe, pump. Okay, you can see the rating of the pump also. It is written over here. I think this is also 0.5 HP. This is 1 HP. You can see it, it will be written somewhere over here. So this is also 0.5 HP. Okay. This is the delivery side of your pump. One valve to regulate the flow. Here you have one valve to regulate the flow. And it is the delivery pipe is coming with this green pipe. And it is going, here you have seen, parallel connection. Yesterday we were studying pipe in parallel connection, pipe in series connection. So this is the case of your parallel connection. This main branch, this is the main pipe. It is distributed into branch pipe one. The second one is going to your branch pipe number two. Okay. So here why we have two setup. On one, the first line, branch pipe one, this venturi meter is there. On branch pipe two, your orifice meter is there. Means on this experimental setup, we will be able to perform two experiments. On this experimental setup, this is entire one experimental setup. On this entire experimental setup, we will be able to perform two experiments. That is calibration of your venturi meter, calibration of your orifice meter. Okay, so you must be thinking, how both the equipments are there? If we have to work only on this venturi meter, then you have to close this one. How we will close this? We have two valves here. If you want to work on this orifice meter, you stop the water flow through this venturi meter. For stopping the water flow, you can close this valve. You can rotate this and you can close this. Or you can open this, whatever you need it. Similarly, this valve, through this valve, you can either allow the water to flow through this pipe or you want to close it. This is how you manage two setups. This is how you manage two setups in a single experimental setup. Okay. So water will be coming. You have to measure the pressure difference. You will change the flow rate by changing this valve position. We will change the flow rate. We will see what is the difference of the mercury column over here. We will note down those values. Then we have to make certain calculations. Okay. Once you do the calculation, again, you have to measure the flow rate. Flow rate. This is our excuse me. Oh, this is sump. Okay. This is your sump. This is your collecting tank. Okay. Here on this collecting tank also, you can see one scale is there. Sir, come closer. This is your collecting tank and the bottom is your sump. Okay. Again, the dimension of this collecting tank is given to you here on this given data. You can see the area of collecting tank is 0.4 meter into 0.4 meter. Okay. Likewise, different specifications for this venturi meter and orifice meter is given here. So what is this area? This is 0.4 meter. This is 0.4 meter. Now, again, we have to measure the flow rate. I told you that we are going to regulate the flow of water through this valve. Okay. So what is the flow rate of water we will measure using this collecting tank? The cross-sectional area is given to you. 0.4 into 0.4. This part you have to perform in each and every experiment, measuring of the flow rate. Okay, 0.4 into 0.4, you have to see the scale over here. scale is marked here. One transparent tube is there. One transparent tube. This tube you can see. Through this you can see what is the level of water inside this tank. Piezometer. Okay. So suppose in this tank the water level is over here. So on this tube the water to this, that location. Okay. Because it is open to atmosphere. This you can see what time it is taking to fill this tank to 10 centimeter. So through this, you can measure the flow rate pipeline. How much flow rate you are opening here. So for flow rate, we will do perform this experiment. Okay. By changing this valve position, we will see how much is the flow rate and what pressure difference that you are getting in that manometer. Okay. And based on that, we will calculate the coefficient of discharge, that is CD value for your venturimeter, for your orifice meter. For your knowledge, I'm telling you the coefficient of discharge for venturimeter is in the range of anyone? Of discharge CD value for your venturi meter, what is the range of that value? We have 35 participants. Can anyone tell me? It is near to 0.98 or 0.99. Around this much you will get. Okay. This is for your venturimeter. It is above 0.9. That you have to remember. The coefficient of discharge of venturimeter is always 0.9 or more than that. Okay. While solving numerical also, suppose at some location some values are missing and teacher says that you can assume certain values as per your requirement. So if CD values of your venturimeter is not given, you can keep it anywhere between 0.9 to less than 1. Means 0.9 to 0.99. Okay, in that range, you can keep this value. Now coming to your orifice meter, what is the practical value of your CD, coefficient of discharge? It is in the range of 0.6. to 0.75. Basically, it is 0.6 to 0.67. But due to some practical errors while performing the experiment, there are certain deviations. Okay, there are many sources of errors also that we will see. So this is about your venturimeter and your orifice meter. This is your orifice. As you know, how your orifice meter looks like? A small, in your pipeline, this blue color is your pipeline. Okay. Inside, this is flange. This is called as flange. Okay. In your CAD CAM, you will learn or you might have studied this. Whether they have gone through this CAD CAM?
CAD CAM, but they are
second. Now they are in third year. Okay. So this is called as your flange. Okay. This is used because inside, in between these two plates, actually, this is two plates. If you will open this nut and bolt, okay, you will see one small plate will be there. One flat plate, very thin plate will be there. And at the center, there will be small hole. That is your orifice. Okay. And this is your orifice meter. Now, can anyone in the classroom open to all? This question is open to everyone. Okay. And I want response. I want to see who is going to answer this. What do you mean by vena contracta? Do anybody remember what is vena contracta? Anyone in the classroom, this question is open to all. What is vena contracta? I have taught you in your theory. Ah, yes, very good.
Least diameter will present, sir.
Yes. One, suppose from this side water is coming. Okay. The direction of water, flow water is in this side. There is one orifice over here. In that orifice plate, one small hole is there. So there is that acts as an obstruction to the path of that fluid. Okay. Through that, once water will come, what will happen after this? At certain location, suppose it may be at certain location, suppose I am considering at here, the flow path will be of minimum diameter. Then again, it will diverge and it will come as per the cross-sectional area of the pipeline. So the location where the fluid streamlines, okay, that fluid lines, you will be having the least area. That least area is your location, is your vena contracta. Very important for your competitive examination point of view. All of you must keep in your mind. They will give you certain definition of vena contracta, and they will ask you in options, option A, option B, option C, and option D. So you have to tick mark on the vena contracta. Okay. So while going through this lab session, you see, this is not just you have to copy your observation values. This is not just doing some calculations. Okay. This is not just about writing your record. It is a process of learning. It is a process of learning. What you have studied in your theory class, you can see here those things practically in front of your eyes. Okay, anyhow, this is now COVID period. Maybe within a month or 2 months, once if you will get time, we will call the students in batches to perform the experiments. Then you will get the real feeling. Okay, a mechanical engineer is nothing without touching these machines. Okay, we cannot perform the experiments virtually until or unless we will see this equipment. Okay, we will see what are the challenges you are facing. It is not like I have told you the experiment. I have told you what are the different components and you will come and you will perform the experiment. Lot of source of errors are there. You have to adjust the valves. Valves characteristics are different. Okay, this is not up to undergraduate level. Okay, there can be some back pressure. I will show you how this back pressure will come. So can you zoom inside this collecting tank? Is it visible? You can see these two pipelines are going. Okay. One is coming from your venturi meter line. Another one is coming from your orifice meter line. This is your collecting tank. Okay. Suppose up to here, at the end of your pipe, water is filled in this collecting tank. Once the water level inside this collecting tank will reach this location. Okay. After that, water will keep on adding to this collecting tank. Water will be added inside this collecting tank. But what will happen? There will be certain back pressure. Thoda piche chale gaye. Entire thing should come. My face also. But what will happen? As I have told you, this pipe extension would be supposed up to this location. Okay. Up to this location, water will be free to accommodate inside this collecting tank. After this, what will happen? That pipe will be inside that water level. So the water present already inside this collecting tank will give some back pressure to the flow of fluid which is coming from this pipe. And its effect will be visible on this manometer. So those things, if you will perform the experiment practically in front of your eyes with your own hands, then only you will see what are the different challenges a mechanical engineer can face. Because these are a simple combination of one pump, one valve, one YouTube manometer. Suppose you are going to some process industries. Suppose you got a job at some petroleum giant like Hindustan Petroleum or Indian Oil. Okay, their refineries, there you will be having, you will be handed over only one section. This entire building, the size of that plant will be 5 times of this entire garage. Okay, and you will be heading for only one section. One section means thousands of valves, thousands of this pressure manometers. Okay, this is only flow control valve. Like this, there are so many other type of valves also. Rotameters to measure the flow rate of the air. There will be reactor. In reactor, there will be so many thermocouples will be there to see the temperature at different locations. Okay, so when you will be working as a real engineer, only thing, it will be scaled up to a very large scale. So here you have to see one valve, one piezometer, one manometer, one venturimeter, one orifice meter. Okay, but when you will be working in a real plant, the number of components will increase. It can be up to 100 or thousands of components will, it will be there. Okay, so you have to understand how they are behaving, which parameter will change if you will rotate this for 5 degrees. So these things you should learn, and this is the prototype of your real job. Similarly, this Bernoulli setup I have shown you earlier. Okay, what we will do in this experiment, again we have a sump in which already water will be there. This is your suction pipe, this is your motor. Okay, what is the rating of this motor? This is also 0.5 hp. All of you, for your bhai bhai, you must keep in your mind, external can ask you what was the rating of the pump that you are using, then you have to tell, sir, it was 0.5 hp. This is the suction line, this is the delivery line. From the delivery line, this green color pipe is there. Again, through this valve you can control the flow rate of the water. Through this valve you can control the flow rate of water, and from this, now it is coming to this cylindrical portion, you can see what is the head, pressure head available over here. It is in, it will give the value in centimeter. This scale is in centimeter. After this, this is your experimental portion where the cross section is changing at different locations. You can see, can you zoom it over here? You can see different tappings are there at different location. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. At different tappings, we are measuring the pressure head. Okay, so as the velocity head will increase up to this location, the pressure head will reduce. So you will see, you will see there will be drop of water level with every section up to this location, up to this middle one. Up to this middle one, there will be drop in pressure head because velocity is increasing, cross section is reducing. After this, what will happen? After this, again, the velocity will reduce and pressure head will increase. So there will be the curve that you will gain. See here, it will be like this. First it will be decreasing, then it will be increasing. So this is how we will do the experiment on your Bernoulli's theorem, or we can say verification of Bernoulli's theorem. What you have studied in theory, Bernoulli's theorem, we will verify it here practically. Okay, now coming to this setup, this is your friction factor calculation. Again, the thing that is common to each and every experiment, here also you have to calculate the mass flow rate. For that mass flow rate, this tank is given, this upper tank, collecting tank. On this tank, you can see here again that piezometer with scale is there. So you have to calculate for 10 centimeter rise how much time it is taking. Okay, the dimension of this collecting tank will be written on the specification. It will be given to 0.3 into 0.3, I think. Yeah. So it will be given to you in the lab manual. Okay, we will provide you the lab manual. So you have to calculate what is the flow rate. Again, you have to change for 3 different flow rates, and you have to verify this for Bernoulli's theorem. Same is here also. Same is here also. Again, you have this collecting tank. the measurement of this collecting tank will be told to you. This collecting tank again is with some scale and this transparent tube, so that you can get some idea where is the water level. You have to measure for 10 centimeter rise, how much time it is taking for rise of 10 centimeter. So you can calculate your volumetric flow rate. Volumetric flow rate, I'm telling you. Okay, this is your sump. This is your pump. This is your valve. Suction side, delivery side. On the delivery side, this valve is there to control the flow rate. Okay, this green pipe is again going to your, this pipeline, this pipeline. Okay, now you have 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4 branches here. One by one we will see. If you will see the top one, this is mild steel. This is your mild steel pipe, stainless steel. Okay, this is your stainless steel. This is your aluminium and this is your copper. So these are the three different pipes through which we will study what are the different friction coefficient factors in it. Okay, the Darcy-Weisbach equation, these are the different tappings in every pipeline you can see. We have one manometer only, okay, but we are able to see the pressure drop across each pipeline using these tappings. It is in closed position. See here. Can you focus it? This is the direction of the pipeline. See, it is coming toward your camera. This is direction. And it is in this direction. So it is closed. Open it, you have to rotate it in this direction. Okay, now it is in open position. So by this closing and opening, we can control the entire pipeline system using only one manometer here. Okay, so this is regarding your friction coefficient measurement for three different pipe materials like stainless steel, aluminium, copper. The fourth line, this is the fourth line. In fourth line, you can see this is the bend. Again, there is one bend. Okay, on this you have so many tappings are there. After this, you can see here expansion. The pipe diameter over here is different. Pipe diameter, this is the smaller diameter. Keep the same frame, okay. And here you can see the diameter is increased. This is the bigger diameter. Bigger diameter and this is the smaller diameter. Yeah. So this is the case of your expansion, pipe expansion. We have studied now. Losses due to pipe expansion, losses due to pipe fittings, losses due to pipe bends. Again, on this side, if you will see, you have contraction. Here the diameter is more, here the diameter is less, here the diameter is less, here the diameter is more. And all the flow we can control using these control valves. These are the flow control valves. Okay, and after this, this line is going to your collecting tank. So these three pipes will give you the major loss and the last one will give you the minor loss. Okay, so this is about your friction factor. These are the specifications for your experiment. For this friction factor, I just today, my target, my objective was to give you a go through. I just want to give you a go through of your fluid mechanics lab. Okay, because teaching theoretically on virtual labs and giving you an experience of, I guess somewhat you have gained some practical experience. You are not here, but virtually you can feel the machines over here. I have shown you all the experimental setups. Okay, so that you will gain some idea when you will be coming here, it will be easier for you to perform the experiments. We will be helping you. You can see here, this is the setup for your centrifugal pump. Centrifugal pump. This is variable speed. It is multi-staged. Now, what is multi-staged? what is single stage. Okay, so that we will see in detail when you will be coming over here. This is variable speed. Using this motor, you can see we can change the bell drives for varying its speed. There is on this side you have one hand lever. Using this we can, yeah, now rotate, yeah, you can see we can change the position, horizontal position of this pump. Okay, one bell drive is there. Using that bell drive we can vary the speed of this pump. This is your motor and this is your pump. Again, if you will see here, what is the rating of this pump? Is it written somewhere? Yeah, 1 HP. This pump is of 1 HP. The previous, all those pumps that you have seen, it was for 0.5 HP. Okay, so this is centrifugal pump. In this casing, this is called as your impeller. Inside this, your impellers or blades will be there, through which at the eye of the impeller, the center location is your eye of the impeller. The water is being sucked, okay, and through, since the impellers are rotating at very high RPM, okay, so those waters are forced to go toward this periphery. Using that centrifugal force, that water is pumped at higher pressure heads. So with that, since its operating principle is centrifugal force is acting over here, so that's why the name is given as centrifugal pump. If we'll come to this reciprocating pump, I will show. Reciprocating pump. This is your reciprocating pump. Again, we need one prime mover. This is our prime mover. That is your motor. Okay, it is rotating this spindle. You can see here the spindle, and through bell drive, one larger pulley. You can see here. It is connected to this one, and this is rotating this portion. Now here we have to convert rotary motion. This is rotating motion. This will give you the rotating motion. Now we have to convert this rotating motion into reciprocating motion. So for that, we need one piston cylinder arrangement. So you can see here one rod is over here. Okay, so it is connected to the outer periphery of this. There will be inside some rotating component, like you have seen in your connecting rod and crank, the rotating. Here we are converting rotating motion into reciprocating motion. This is your piston or plunger, you can say, and it is sucking and delivering, pumping the water. This is positive displacement type of pump. Always, this question is very important. In your Viva, they may ask you which one is your positive displacement pump. So then you have to tell that reciprocating pump is positive displacement pump, because in every cycle it will pump some liquid. Only difference will be the flow rate. Normally in industry it is measured in LPM, liters per minute, or LPH, like that. Okay, so this I have shown you the reciprocating pump also. Besides this, these three experimental setups are, this is your Pelton wheel I have shown you earlier. Besides this Pelton wheel, at the end of this laboratory you are having this Francis turbine. This is your turbine. And you will see one important component at this location, this pipe with gradually increasing diameter. Important question for your external examination. Why this pipe we are connected here with gradually increasing diameter? This is called as draft tube. What is draft tube? What is the function of draft tube? Okay. And what are the different types of draft tubes? That we will study in your unit number 5. Very important theoretical question for your exam point of view. After this, again we have The last setup here, that is your Copland turbine. Okay, here you can see one bigger venturi meter is there. This venturi meter is bigger one. Okay, here you can see the converging portion, throat portion, diverging portion. Two tappings are there. That is to measure the pressure difference. Okay, what is the pressure here? That there we were using YouTube manometer. Here we are using this pressure gauges because here the pressure is high. Okay, so we cannot use those YouTube manometers for high pressure instruments. And this will be your turbine. This is the closer look. It is inside this casing. Okay, and again you will be having that same. You can see here. I'm focusing on the delivery side. You can see a pipe with gradually increasing diameter. Okay, this is again that draft tube is there. From theory point of view, this is very important. Okay, so this is all about your lab. Virtual walk through of this lab. I have shown you all the experimental setups. I tried to give you a glimpse of some theoretical aspects, what you have studied in your theory subject, and how we can correlate this with your lab. So this is what I have done. If you have anything to ask, you can ask me. How many participants do we have now? We have 28 participants. If you have anything to ask me, you can ask. Or in the next week, we will perform one experiment. Okay, as today I have shown you different experimental setups, how they are working. In next week, I will start one system and show you how to perform the experiment. Step by step, I will show you. Okay, how to note down the readings, what are the readings to be noted, how to do the calculation, all the things I will show you in next week. This is all from my side. If you have any question, you are free to ask. Yes, anyone? Or if you have no question, then we can stop the class here. If it is clear and helpful for today's session, please now type in the chat box. What is your experience? Whether did you like this, the way of taking the lab, or you are comfortable with that virtual lab? You type in the chat box about the experience of today's class. I want to see. All of you type in the chat box and then you can leave the class. Very good. One student has written, wonderful experience, sir. Very good. Actually, whatever the comments, if the comments or the feedback, basically, some positive feedback came, then it fuels us, the positive energy from inside. Okay. So that we can, as a teacher always wanted to give best to their student. Okay, if there is something where we are lagging, so you must tell us so that we can work out and give the best to our students. Anyhow, one thing from the first class I am telling you, there is no shortcut to hard work. Okay, teacher will guide you. Teacher will guide you, but ultimately, hard work is to be done by you people only. Okay, this is the time you are shaping your career. Okay, this is the time where you are shaping your career. After this BTech, you have to enter into the real market. Okay, so do hard work, stay safe, stay inside, all the best. I'm stopping the meeting.